This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring, from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing 282 pounds, the man who claims to be Canada's greatest athlete, Iron Mike Sharpe.
A bit of irony, I think, and that, as we mentioned earlier, Ken Patera, former Olympian, the first man to military press, 500 pounds, that has to impress even you, Jesse.
Oh, it does impress me. You know, the guy is the typical example, plenty of brawn, but no brains.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, he's done.
And I don't care about that he got some diploma, some, you know, GED course from college or whatever it is that he graduated.
Well, you know, yes, he has done something you haven't done. That, of course, is graduate from college, Brigham Young University recently. But you know something else that I believe Ken Patera has accomplished that you have not?
What's that?
That is, he's on the cover of the World Wrestling Federation magazine. Have you ever been on the cover of the magazine?
No, but then again, that's all politics involved there.
I see.
Jack Tunney approves all those covers. You think Jack Tunney's going to do anything for me?
Ken Patera, who just a couple of weeks ago made what you thought was going to be a fatal mistake.
It was a fatal mistake. He took the beating of his life from the Heenan family.
I think it was more of a humiliating tactic on the part of Heenan than it was rehabilitated.
Definitely.
The Meadowlands Arena, East Rutherford, New Jersey. The next World Wrestling Federation date at that beautiful building. It's Saturday, and there will be a title match involving your champion, Hulk Hogan, who certainly is not a happy champion at this moment. Mr. Hogan looking forward to Killer Khan, his opponent, the number one contender. Major dues perhaps to be paid by Mr. Khan towards Hulk at the Meadowlands Arena, the main event, Saturday night, August 1st.
You see there, Patera left himself wide open. He come walking in with his hands held high. Hot-dogging it a little, if you ask me.
I don't think he was hot-dogging at all. Patera now whips in a buckle for the ride. Here comes Mike Sharpe, who misses. Patera with a kick across the head and another one. The former Olympian backing Mike Sharpe up to the ropes, trying to set him up, I believe. Off the ropes and a clothesline by Patera.
You forgot also the former jailbird.
All right, come on. That's enough for that, Jesse.
Well, let's get the background straight.
The man paid his dues.
From the Olympics to jail.
He paid his debt to society. It's over with.
Yes, but I don't believe he's paid his debt to Heenan yet.
Yeah, well, look at him go. I'll tell you what, they'd love to get any of Heenan's so-called family in that ring right now.
And I'll say this, society is going to be a lot easier on him than Heenan ever will be.
That remains to be seen. Ken Patera with big Iron Mike Sharpe. He's a tough customer. The Sharpe, bear hunt by Ken Patera. And Sharpe wastes no time at all. It's a bidding.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring, from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing 282 pounds, the man who claims to be Canada's greatest athlete, Iron Mike Sharpe. His opponent, accompanied towards ringside by his new manager, Oliver Humperdinck, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Paul Orndorff, Mr. Wonderful, gets quite an ovation here from this capacity crowd. Paul Orndorff just last week fired Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Well, to me, Paul Orndorff's a mixed up man. He don't know where he's going. I mean, he's fired twice now. Two times he's fired Bobby Heenan. And Mike Sharp's going after him to teach him a lesson, I think.
Iron Mike Sharp duking it out with Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Earlier on, we had an occasion to chat with Bobby the Brain Heenan and Rick Rude. I should say, ravishing Rick Rude. Here's Bobby the Brain Heenan and Mr. Rude.
I'll tell you one thing, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Who do you think you are firing me? You've embarrassed me for the last time. And every member of my family's gonna get even with you. I know you're jealous of this man. He's got the best physique in professional sports today. We're gonna get you, Orndorff, if you can bank on it.
Bobby the Brain Heenan in his commentary as Iron Mike now makes his way back into the ring. Yes, Heenan was humiliated last week. I must say, I enjoyed that.
Yeah,
I really enjoyed it.
I'm sure you would. I question Mr. Wonderful, because who knows the credentials of this Oliver Humperdinck? I mean, Heenan's a proven commodity.
Heenan's a proven commodity?
That's right.
You heard what Orndorff says. He was very unhappy with Heenan, extremely unhappy. He didn't want to be unhappy anymore.
Orndorff's a totally confused man. He don't know what he wants.
Oh, but you certainly do, don't you, Joe?
That's right.
Poughkeepsie, New York means the Mid-Hudson Civic Center, and when the World Wrestling Federation comes to Poughkeepsie, great action is not that far behind. On the date of Tuesday, September 8th, you will see on the card Outlaw Ron Bass, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, and the Junkyard Dog. Just some of the great stars headed to the Mid-Hudson Civic Center, Poughkeepsie, New York, Tuesday night, September the 8th.
Well, I'll tell you, Orndorff's trying to prove something.
Put on the rope, Mr. Paul. Oh, my goodness, not anymore. Not anymore. Humperdinck. Looking on.
You know, I'll say one thing about Humperdinck. He sure ain't going to win no beauty contest.
I'll grant you that. Yes.
I mean, I definitely don't think he's in Playgirl's top 10 for best-looking men.
No, but I don't know. I don't know why Bruno didn't make it.
I do look.
I was wrong.
That's a good one, McMahon. I like that one.
Iron Mike in control of things at the moment. Orndorff being set up by Iron Mike to the ropes. Oh, yes, downstairs goes Iron Mike.
Well, Iron Mike Sharp's a tough competitor. You're not going to get no easy win over this guy. As Wonderful's finding out right now. Maybe he's wishing he had Heenan back right now.
I doubt that. Nice reversal. Off the rope now. Nice clothesline by Orndorff. Yes, we may see the power driver. Paul Orndorff cinches up. Mike trying to kick out. Now has him up and...
Well, Sharp did everything he could to block that pile driver, but he couldn't get away with it. He tried to sit down on it, but Mr. Wonderful was a little too powerful and got him up.
Oh, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff.
Here's the winner, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Look at that ugly little Humperdinck.
This is a tag team contest scheduled for one fall. Introducing first to my right at a total combined weight of 477 pounds, B. Brian Blair, Jumping Tim Brunzell, the Killer Bees.
You know, for once in my life, I wish they had the masks on. I don't have to look at their faces.
A total combined weight of 531 pounds from Brooklyn, New York, Steve Lombardi. His partner claiming to be Canada's greatest athlete from Hamilton, Ontario, Iron Mike Sharp.
We've just been given notification that apparently we're going to hear word from the Slickster and Nikolai Volkov as to what happened earlier on, of course, where Slick was totally embarrassed. What a surprise. And let me ask you a question, Jesse.
Ask it, if you're capable.
All the way down the line, you were right there with the elimination of each manager, one by one.
That's right.
Did you know that was going to happen?
No, I didn't. I'll tell you what and how I feel about this Oliver Humperdinck character. I don't know who this guy think he is coming into the World Wrestling Federation. First he causes Orndorff to fire Heenan. Now somehow, subversively, He manages to get Bam Bam away from Slick. I think this little fat troll Humperdinck is going to pay some dues.
You do, huh?
Yeah, he's making a lot of enemies, and I don't think that squatty little fat man can stand up to it.
Well, apparently, later on, we're going to hear from Slick and Volkoff relative to, apparently, the challenge that was made.
You know, the bees are at a great disadvantage in this bout here.
Why?
They can't do their normal cheating with those masks. They don't have them on.
Count of two, they almost won the match right there.
They can't do any of that illegal in and out of the ring where the referee don't know which one's in there, where me as the announcer don't know which one's in there.
You as the announcer who doesn't know how to use the King's English.
The King's English, are we in England?
Oh, my goodness.
I use good old-fashioned American slang, the way it's taught in schools.
B. Brian Blair.
I ain't got no use for the King's English.
Would you please stop it?
Remember, a double negative means a positive.
In your book, I'm sure it does.
No, that's also in physics.
Tag is made. Frequent tags now by the Killer Bees. Jumping Jim Brunzell in there.
Oh, the Bees are an accomplished team. They work well together in that ring. They know each other very well. Brunzell going for a figure four, but in comes Big Iron Mike.
Mike Sharpe, a tough one.
Would you try doing play-by-play and get me? I'm the color man, McMahon. Get with it.
Well, Jess, you're such a movie star these days.
Oh, I mean, don't try to soften me up. Don't try to get on my good side.
Believe me, I won't. Iron Mike trying to set up. Jumping Jim Brunzell off the rope. Brunzell, Mike missing with a roundhouse right. Great body press, nicely done. Count of two. Frenzy unable to hook the leg of Big Iron Mike. Tag made, Lombardi coming in.
Now Brunzell made a mistake. He got caught in the wrong corner. Lombardi and Sharpe will do some damage here. I think he's trying to give him a cauliflower ear.
Lombardi with jumping Jim Brunzell. Tag made, here comes Big Iron Mike back. Look at this double teaming going on.
All legal. They're getting in and out of there in time. You have a five count.
Iron Mike and Lombardi, quite impressive. Then again, so are the Killer Bees. Back body drop. Missing with the elbow.
Now, if you look, Mike Sharpe made a gross mistake there. He didn't keep his eye on Brunzell when he went up for that elbow.
Brunzell trying to make a tag against B. Brian Blair. Blair going downstairs, now upstairs. Another one upstairs. B. Brian Blair with Iron Mike Sharpe trying to set him up. Whips him to the rope now. Hit it off. Back body drop. And more than that as well. Iron Mike, nice reversal by Iron Mike, missing with the roundhouse. Collision here. A cover, caught him with a bee sting. Oh, look at that!
Whoa! Lombardi hit his own marker.
Runs out. Tagged in now. Iron Mike coming out. What's going to happen? Look at that drop kick.
Credit where it's due. They finally won a match without the masks. Finally.
They don't need the masks.
Here are your winners, the Killer Bees.
Killer Bees, there's something else.
This next bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, making his way to the ring area from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing 247 pounds, Jake the Snake Roberts.
And Damien.
His opponent from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing 271 pounds, claiming to be Canada's greatest athlete, Iron Mike Sharpe.
Iron Mike Sharpe, self-proclaimed Canada's greatest athlete. I don't believe he ever have had to deal with Damien.
This is going to be a good one.
You're going to have to deal with Damien somewhere down the road.
No way.
No,
I don't like reptiles.
You know, the cobra is the deadly enemy of the mongoose, and I guess the python that Damien is the deadly enemy of the weasel. Is that?
I wouldn't know anything about little furry animals either.
Didn't think so. You know, Brain, even though you're on the cover of the October issue of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, still, there's a lot of good stuff inside the magazine.
Well, certainly, but mainly because I'm on the cover. You know, you can tell a lot about a man by what he likes. The wrestling magazine asks all the wrestlers, what is their favorite cities?
Uh-huh.
Outback Jack, he says he likes Humpty Doo.
That's his home.
Wherever that is. But the King, Harley Race, he knows style. He likes Monte Carlo.
What would the King know about Monte Carlo?
He goes there on vacation a lot to Europe and gamble.
Oh.
They treat him like royalty over there, which he is.
Now, if you really want to catch up and know about the individuals here in the World Wrestling Federation, the magazine is a place to do that. There's a special interview session in this latest edition with George the Animal Steel that really gives you some insight as to what this guy's all about. You think you know the animal? You don't.
But who's on the cover?
Uh-huh. I know who's. I won't be able to live with you now. I know that. Oh, nice trip move by the snake. Oh, stretch out those hamstrings. One time. Now, if you could win a match verbally, Iron Mike would be undefeated.
Yeah, he would. He's loud.
Jake the Snake Roberts, all business inside that squared circle.
Would you like me to autograph a copy of that for you?
No, thanks. You mean you can actually buy a copy? You haven't bought them all?
See, October, I haven't bought them all.
I'm sure you have several thousand copies.
For my friends?
Yeah. For your friends, you only need the one you got right here. Dropping the leg on him, Jake the Snake going to work very methodically now on Iron Mike Sharpe, who really should, maybe pack it in, because there's a guy who's had a bad forearm now for 9 years.
He's had maybe it's just to protect him from another injury.
It's a weapon, that's all it is. Irank stopped Jake dead in his tracks. I'll tell you, he's a big roughhouse, raw-bone guy, talking about Iron Mike Sharpe.
Whoa!
He riled up the Snake. Unloading on him now. Irish whip into the corner. Follows him right into a stiff knee. Right downstairs.
Cradle him now, Mike. Go behind him, cradle him, and hook the ropes. I mean, hook his leg.
You want to manage this guy now? Don't you have enough problems?
I don't have any problems.
You're one short in the stable now.
I don't have a stable. I'm not one short.
Well, yeah, you're one short. Mr. Wonderful took a little height ski on you.
I was going to dump him anyway.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. Oh, put his head down. Carved a mistake made by the big guy from Canada.
What are they chanting? DDT? DDT?
You got it. DDT. Oh, gave that short clothesline. That sets it up. He gave the signal for it. We're going to take a look at it. And perhaps a look at Damien as well. Scoops him in that front face lock. Watch his drop.
Oh.
Really buried him. Listen to the crowd.
I'll tell you one thing. A lot of people in wrestling have copied this move, but only one man does it like this guy.
Absolute fact.
Thank you.
As we look at that ominous green bag, look at the look on the kisser of Jake. He's going over.
But he's not on the cover. I am.
Look, that bag's moving around right now.
Of course it's moving. A 20-foot snake in that bag.
We're going to take a look at it. Referee pleading with him. No, please don't open it. No, stall. Look at that. He's going to lay it on him. He drove the referee out of there.
Now that thing's dangerous, Monsoon.
You betcha. Oh, look at that. Look. What a feeling that must be.
Here is your winner, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Introducing first to my left, from Seattle, Washington, weighing 220 pounds, Brady Boone. His opponent claims to be Canada's greatest athlete. From Hamilton, Ontario, at 282 pounds, Iron Mike Sharpe.
Having got those announcements out of the way, Mike Sharpe, who proclaims himself as being Canada's greatest athlete, although I would imagine that's up for debate, arguing already with the referee. He certainly is a bundle of energy, but he faces a youngster in Brady Boone, who certainly knows his way around the ring.
Exactly. I think you're going to be impressed with him, Lord Alfred. He's the kind of man I think you would be impressed with. But it's not starting out that way.
Mike letting his presence be known not only to Brady Boone, but to this packed audience here
exactly.
at the Boston Gardens.
Well, you know, Lord Alfred, for years, Iron Mike Sharpe has been one of the dominant forces in professional wrestling.
He has, and if he can intimidate his opponent, he'll use any method.
Exactly.
I've always said that Iron Mike, if it moves, he'll drop kick it. If it doesn't move, he'll hit it with a tackle or try and slam it or climb up it or something or
exactly.
run over it. Just a heavy blow there by Mike. Another one.
You know, Lord Alfred, it's a shame Iron Mike can't seem to throw off that injury to that right arm. You know, he's had that injury there for quite a few years.
Oh, some terrific maneuvers there by young Brady Boone. And now Mike taking a hike, coming right across the table here, and nearly destroying everything, including you and I, Slick. Mike trying to think this one out. Brady, two beautifully timed arm drags. And now look at Mike, he's arguing with everybody. I think he's coming back this way again.
Mike recollecting his thoughts.
Well, I don't know what thoughts he has, but he doesn't seem to put them together too well.
Well, he didn't then, but I think the man's going to come on now.
Brady Boone, a comparative newcomer to the WWE. Lacking a little in the bodyweight division, but certainly not lacking in skills.
Well,
nice move there.
He's very quick and very agile, and that has its effect.
Just a two count there by Brady. And Mike once again complaining. And the referee remonstrating with Iron Mike, but you can't tell what is in Iron Mike's mind. The same way you don't ever know what he's going to do next.
I don't think Mike knows what he's going to do next sometime.
I think you're right there.
Well, he certainly seems to be proud of himself right now, and he should be.
Well, he's a big, solid man. And Brady ran into the immovable object there. He's going to try it again. Oh, nice move by Brady. Good dropkick. Nice arm drag once again by Brady. Two arm drags. And Mike decides to head for cover again.
Well, you know, Lord, I'll have to give Boone credit for one thing. He seems to be able to get Mike off balance quite a bit here.
He does. He's mustered a very good offense against this huge Canadian, and he seems to be doing extremely well. We could be in for an upset here.
If I were managing Mike right now, I'd tell him to go into the ring, slow the pace down, regain his composure, and take his time, and just use his strength on this guy. See what I'm talking about? See how he overpowered him there.
I think he must have heard you, Slick.
That's why I'm the greatest in this business today, brother.
Slick, you're certainly doing extremely well in the realms of the WWF.
Exactly.
Do you have any plans for a world championship match against Hogan?
Exactly. The big 747, brother. That's my plan. To send a one-man gang after Hulk Hogan. Just as soon as Hogan will settle down and sign a contract.
We're certainly going. Oh, high backdrop there. Wow. Brady must have been 15 feet up in the air then. Slick, we're certainly going to see one-man gang. You seriously believe that this man can beat Hulk Hogan?
Let me tell you the difference between the one-man gang and other super heavyweights in this business today. He's the only 400-pounder that can do drop kicks, suplexes, flying head scissors. He can do it all, brother.
You think you might be giving away a little bit too much when you talk about his strategies like drop kicking?
But I didn't say when or where he would do it, brother.
Oh, nice roll back here by Brady. Got him trapped. But unfortunately, not enough weight to keep the big Canadian down. A mighty right by Iron Mike to young Brady. Another crashing right. Referee beginning to put the count on Iron Mike, and Mike bending the rules, and if he's not careful, he'll bend them just a little too far and find himself marching away from the ring.
Exactly. You know how the officials are in the World Wrestling Federation.
Hard slam into the turnbuckle. Brady, at this moment, beginning to tire a little, and that's no wonder against somebody like Iron Mike.
I think Mike's size is about to take its effect upon Brady Boone.
It certainly seems to be taking its toll, although the youngster's managed to reverse it. Coming in, mounting right up there. Oh, good move by Brady. Just managed to make contact with that dropkick. Made contact with that one too, but still not sufficient.
Went to the well one time too many. Now this, really this is where I think Mike is making a mistake. The man is dazed. He should be over there on him.
Well, Mike is not noted for taking his time, but he's certainly doing it this evening. Maybe somebody's told him to slow down his style a bit. It would appear to me as well, Slick, as if he's adjusting that nasty leather little piece he has on his right forearm.
I don't know what you're insinuating, Lord, but you know that's from an old injury. You know that.
Well, he's had an old injury for quite a few years. When is it going to heal up?
Well, you know, brother, sometimes bones take a long time to mend.
Well, okay, Slick.
Right there, this man should be disqualified.
Slick, that was a drop across the inside thigh.
I don't know. That's questionable, Lord Alfred. That's questionable. It looked low to me.
I don't think so, Slick. And Mike doesn't seem to be complaining too much about it. The youngster taking this match now, too. The big Canadian. Oh, a mighty blow by that.
Right there is where he made a mistake. He gave his stuff away. He ducked his head too soon.
A mighty blow by that forearm piece that Mike has there.
My God, that hurt me.
Heavy blow to the midsection of Brady. And for the last 2 or 3 minutes, Brady has been on the wrong end of the punishment here. And that might have been a mistake.
Exactly. He has a man hurt. He should be working on him in the ring, taking advantage of it.
Well, Mike never does the logical things.
I'm inclined to agree with you for once.
Mike likes to get his men in and beat them up, keep on top of them.
This is where a manager comes in handy. He needs a guiding force like the Slickster, baby, over his career. I'd have him on top of that guy like white on white right now, brother.
You think you could do something for Big Mike?
Exactly.
Holding him across those ropes, in danger of being disqualified. The referee now.
If you ask me, I think it's just a matter of time.
Well, Brady Boone hasn't been able to do a lot this last few minutes, but Iron Mike is certainly wasting his time, and sometimes this is a definite mistake.
Exactly.
Give him the youngster time to recover.
My sentiments, exactly. He's just letting him recover.
Boone getting back into the ring long before he should have, showing a little inexperience there. Iron Mike throws him in, tries that clothesline, misses. Oh, big back elbow by Brady Boone.
But it took a lot out of Boone, too. Mike can still stay on top of him here.
Boone beginning to muster an attack. That strength coming back into that frame again. Oh, nearly a 1-2-3 there. Not quite enough strength in Boone to hold that at the moment. But he's becoming more and more inspired.
Fast count by the referee, too.
Oh! Iron Mike was very lucky there. The referee saw that foot on the ropes at the last possible moment.
He's using a fist, Lord Alfred. That's illegal. The referee should be on top of this.
Well, they didn't appear to be full knuckle shots to me, but probably they were, because the referee is definitely reprimanded. And while we're talking, it seems to me that Iron Mike put something into the arm.
I don't think so. I didn't see anything.
And it
like
certainly
that.
Looks that way, because Boone is unconscious.
Are you sure you know what you're talking about?
He's
now
absolutely down and out.
I must have missed it. I didn't see anything like that.
And the referee is talking to Howard Finkel. I think we ought to go to the ring now to get the official verdict.
The winner of this contest, Iron Mike Sharpe.
Madison Square Garden, Gorilla Monsoon, along with Nick Bockwinkel. Nick, I have to make this observation.
I was not surprised to see you come out here, because I've learned that nothing is surprising that happens in the world of professional wrestling, but I was surprised at the fan reaction, or the lack of fan reaction.
Well, there didn't seem to be a lack of it, but it just goes to show you, even a city like
they recognize
doesn't have taste.
Yeah, let's go up to
this contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring, the man who claims to be Canada's greatest athlete, from Hamilton, Ontario, weighing 282 pounds, Iron Mike Sharpe. Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, making his return to the Madison Square Garden ring, from Krakow, Poland, weighing 245 pounds, Polish power, Ivan Putski.
The Polish power, Ivan Putski, makes his way down to a tremendous ovation here in the Garden. Certainly been a long time since we've seen Ivan here in the World Wrestling Federation. He looks to be in great shape.
Yes, he does. Very, very much so. As far as that goes, I like to say, like away from Mike Sharpe.
Well, I'm sure Mike Sharpe claiming to be Canada's greatest athlete. I'm sure guys like Wayne Gretzky might have something to say about that.
I'm sure they would, but I mean, anybody can claim it.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I don't think there's any better conditioned athlete right now in the World Wrestling Federation better than Iron Mike Sharpe. He's a fanatic about that.
As I understand, that is exactly the truth. Of course, he's second generation, like myself,
yes,
and like a number of others.
Back it out. He wants to think about this a little bit. Always does his homework.
Yes, he does. A lot of times people say, well, why would a man step out like that? And of course, it can simply be just strategy. You can break the tempo of another athlete, break it off very easily by doing just that. I mean, especially if he gets the roll up. Well, now we're running into the first problem that Putski's got.
Which is?
Well, I mean, egotistically, what's he going to do? Stand in front of the mirror or become here to wrestle?
Well, he's obviously doing some heavy posing here.
Yes.
He's a powerhouse.
But, I mean, he's looking at a man 282 pounds. He ain't going to pose him down. He's going to have to wrestle him down. Absolutely.
Obviously not. Got a nice tan as well. Obviously spent some time in the warmer climates, which you like to frequent.
Absolutely. My condo in Hawaii, my condo in Florida.
Understand the brain is contemplating buying some additional properties down in Hawaii, as well as his Beverly Hills estate.
I'm sure.
Standing wrist lock by Iron Mike, asking Putski if he wants to quit. Highly unlikely. Should be able to power out of this, even with the height advantage. Turned it around.
But actually, the height advantage was not. Actually, it was a disadvantage at that time, because Putski had the center of gravity, so to speak, underneath him, and was able to use Mike's extra height against him.
To his disadvantage.
Exactly.
Full Nelson, I don't believe this will work either. Doesn't appear that he even got the fingers locked to begin with.
Well, if you don't lock the fingers, then
forget about it.
Yes.
Now he's got his hands locked in there and can't get him out. Complaining to the referee, finally takes it to the ropes. And the referee's still a little bit reluctant about breaking it.
Actually, the armband and the wristband that Mike Sharpe has probably is preventing him from getting his arms out.
Yes. Well, that particular forearm support has been on there for about 7 years now. That has to be the slowest healing injury I've ever seen.
As long as the referee checked it out and there was no object or any brace or metal brace underneath it, it doesn't make a difference.
Look out, like a freight train, ran into Putski, who just took a couple steps back, trying it again. Two bulls.
You got that right.
Well, went for a drop kick, nobody home. Sort of knocked the wind out of him, so.
I'm sure it did. Finesse has not really been the strong suit in this match yet. It's been strictly power, strictly strength.
We're seeing a good demonstration of it right now. Squashed the fingers all up and then tried to straighten them out.
I think Mike Sharpe, for the conditioning I understand that he has, should actually be making Putski chase him a little bit. See if he can run him down. Because if Putski's got a lot of strong muscles, as most men with a lot of muscles, they're good for a short period of time, but not for the long haul.
Absolute fact. Tank could get empty in a hurry.
Absolutely. A semi-trailer, big 18-wheeler with a flat tire, no gas in it. Tank just hits on the road.
Oh, got a steel chair. Referee's going to stop him here before he even enters the ring with it. Because that could run into a lot of dollars as well. Side headlock. Oh, stuck the thumb right into the esophagus area. That'll slow you down. I don't care how good you are.
Absolutely. If you can't get oxygen to the motor stops running. And that's exactly what takes place there. You foul with the esophagus, and he can't breathe. He's gonna, all the strength in the world that he's got is going to be useless.
In control right now. Look at this. Leverage moves. He steps right over that top rope. It's a blatant chokehold.
It's a terrific place to pitch your seat.
Referee trying physically to stop him. That's not the way to do it. Rulebook says you make it count. If the guy has a break, you disqualify.
But it's still a judgment call on the part of the referee, too. I mean, if Pusky's hanging on the ropes, yeah, it's just not sharp. That was holding up.
Oh, ooh, what a chop.
Good chop.
They heard that way up on 50th Street. Starting to unload now with a heavy artillery, Iron Mike. Putski downstairs to the breadbasket. Seems to have an effect. I didn't think he would be that successful downstairs because I know the kind of conditioning Sharpe has. Now they're just pulling out all the stops. Right?
Yep, I hate to say it, it's breaking down into a first-class street fight. A little football in here, too.
Oh, rammed out of there. Nobody home. That shoulder, that right shoulder, it appeared to ram the steel post. Hard to tell from our vantage point whether it did or not.
First brain move on the part of Putski all night.
Putski now unloading with lefts and rights. Maybe we'll see that Polish hammer. Sends him in for the ride. There it is. Oh, he nailed him with it. Forget about it. This one is history.
Yes, it is.
And Putski winding up with that big hammer really lowered the boom.
Polish power!
Polish power indeed. Let's get the official word.
Your winner, Polish power, Ivan Putski.
Putski very successful in his return here to Madison Square Garden.
Well, one thing that Ken Patera and Billy Jack Haynes certainly have in common, that is their dislike for the team of demolition, Axe and Smash. But in the ring right now, Iron Mike Sharpe firing off into the midsection of Ken Patera with that right forearm, and Patera out of the way. Nice hip toss. Scoop slam by the Olympian Ken Patera. He puts those boots to Mike Sharpe. Ken Patera is not a man that you want to get riled early in a match.
I question whether or not the legality of the arm brace that he's got on. We know he was injured. We know his arm was operated on. But as far as I'm concerned, a brace should be supportive. And that one looks like it's a lot more to me than just supportive.
That's an orthopedic brace, Nick. You know what the purpose of that is.
Well, the orthopedic, that's a wonderful word. But, I mean, is an orthopedic brace supposed to be in a wrestling match?
Well, some might argue Mike Sharpe's orthopedic brace that he wears, and a lot of times Sharpe has been known to use that brace to his advantage.
I've seen him put it on in the dressing room. It is nothing more than leather that goes over a wrist that has been weakened.
Such as Ken Patera.
Yeah. I don't think Ken Patera enjoys wearing that orthopedic brace.
Not at all.
It's something that he has to wear.
Mike Sharpe sends Billy Jack Haynes into the corner and follows it up, but nobody's home.
One thing, you talk about strength of Patera, how about the full Nelson of Billy Jack Haynes? My opinion, Bruce, best one in the World Wrestling Federation.
Very true, and Billy Jack Haynes introducing Van Horn to that canvas.
I would like to think that a crowd favorite would be able to make a move without having to drive a man's face into the mat by having both of his hands full of the man's hair.
Ken Patera coming off that top rope.
With the orthopedic brace, as you gentlemen wish to call it.
With the forearm, and Patera sends Van Horn on the outside of the ring and goes right out after him.
Sure. He's got to slam him on the cement. The padding on the cement is very, very thin. It's a tremendous shock to the system. Why couldn't he keep him in the ring and do the same thing?
I don't think Van could stay in it. What is his first name, by the way? Is it Van?
Van Horn.
What's his first name?
Van.
And his middle name?
Not sure what his middle name is.
Man, Papa,
is Van Horn, Ken Patera.
I'm glad your phraseologists have gotten that one straightened out.
Patera sending Van Horn into the ropes. Backdrop. Drops the elbow and Patera.
No. Drops a nice orthopedic brace.
That's covering that injured arm and elbow of Ken Patera. Shoulder breaker. And Patera continues to punish Van Horn.
Got to be very impressed with the tag team company. It's relatively new. Patera and Billy Jack Haynes work together well.
Very true.
You have to say all three of them work together well. Patera, Jack Haynes, Billy Jack, and the orthopedic brace.
Billy Jack now in, and the chop sends Van Horn to the mat with a thud. Haynes, a scoop slam. And Haynes almost seems to be playing with Van Horn at this point.
He may be just sizing him up, perhaps, for the full Nelson. Look at that test of strength.
High vertical suit play, and Haynes showing some tremendous wrestling ability, Nick.
Well, at this point, he's demonstrating a lot of strength, which I will admit he has. Both him and Patera are known to be extremely strong. They use their strength. But as far as articulate skill and wrestling ability, I question that.
Ken Patera sending Van Horn under the mat, a knee into the smaller back of Van Horn. And you've seen a new aggressiveness in the style of Ken Patera and Billy Jack Haynes since their feud with Demolition. They are not taking a back seat to anyone.
I'll tell you what, they better show some aggressiveness, because Demolition is one team that if you just think you can go out there, what they have done up to this point might be sufficient for the people that they are in the ring against tonight at this moment. But I'm not so sure that that's going to do it.
And Billy Jack Haynes now cinching on that full Nelson for what she has patented. And it's all over. It's all over.
I'll tell you what, he showed you a heck of a full Nelson.
Here are your winners, the team of Billy Jack Haynes and former Olympic great Ken Patera.
Soon to be pushing ringside from Glens Falls, New York, weighing 280 pounds.
Never did that at all.
His opponent, claiming to be Canada's greatest athlete, from Hamilton, Ontario, at 282 pounds, Iron Mike Sharpe.
You know what interests me? I just wonder, when Duggan goes out at night, do you think he dances with that 2x4 too? I mean, he seems to carry it everywhere. Sits down for lunch and feeds the 2x4.
I don't know about that. Tell you one thing.
He's the only man in the world I know that walks around with a board.
His capacitive cuff is right behind him. Harley Race will no doubt be looking on. As a matter of fact, we had an occasion to chat with Mr. Race a little bit before the broadcast. Here's what the self-professed king has to say.
As you humble peasants can see, that the crown and the robe are back with the rightful king, the only king. And Duggan, you fall right back in that category as a mere simple peasant.
Lying back up.
You know, I figured it out. I figured out why Duggan's successful. He's so unorthodox in that ring. That's what gives him his success. This guy don't wrestle like a normal wrestler.
I'll grant you that.
He's like three cards short of a full deck, no doubt about it.
Another great World Wrestling Federation event heads to the Cumberland County Civic Center in Portland, Maine on Sunday, December 6th. It's an afternoon event at 2 p.m. Among those on the bill, the Ultimate Warrior, Dino Bravo, Jake the Snake Roberts, the Strike Force, King Kong Bundy. Many of your favorites headed to Portland, Maine at the Cumberland County Civic Center on Sunday afternoon, December 6th.
Why does he howl in the ring?
Hey, how do I know? Why does Mike Sharpe scream like a wounded eagle?
Better yet, why did I ask you in the first place, Bruno?
Why did you?
I don't know. I must be getting senile in my old age.
Wow, what kind of a question is that? How am I supposed to know why he hollers?
Well, you said before that Duggan is very, very unorthodox.
He is.
Duggan will do things that no one else will do. And to stop this man, it's like trying to stop a freight train.
Well, he's a big man. He's very strong. He is different, but I thought he can take a lot, and he can sure give a lot.
Off the rope. Going underneath. Duggan now with a shoulder block.
No doubt in my mind this guy hears voices.
He's what?
There's no doubt in my mind that Hacksaw Jim Duggan hears people talking to him. He could be in a lone room and I bet he hears voices.
He hears this right now too. Down. Set. Here he comes at him. Shoulder block and a clothesline on top. Puts the leg and gets the three count.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. Currently in the ring at 265 pounds, self-proclaimed Canada's greatest athlete, Iron Mike Sharpe. His opponent at 275 pounds from parts unknown, the Ultimate Warrior!
The Ultimate Warrior making his way to the ring, and he is an awesome physical specimen! Hello everyone, Bruce Pritchard at ringside along with Mike McGurk and Duke Doherty as we get set to watch these two huge individuals and this man in particular, the Ultimate Warrior!
This Ultimate Warrior has gone local because Mike Sharpe, Iron Mike Sharpe, is gonna drive him through the mat.
Yeah, the Ultimate Warrior, a truly awesome physical specimen. But you can't count Mike Sharpe out, Mike.
No, you can't. He's been in the World Wrestling Federation for quite a while and has proved himself.
Look at the confidence on Mike Sharpe, will ya? He's ready to go.
Now look at the power of the Ultimate Warrior with ease setting Mike Sharpe up on that top turnbuckle.
I'll have to say that Ultimate Warrior is showing some spectacular strength being able to pick up Mike Sharpe, who's a good 200 and about 270 pounds easy. Picked him up like he was nothing.
And the Warrior anxiously awaiting Iron Mike Sharp's return to the ring, ready to get this battle underway. Sharpe going into the ropes, but the Warrior's not going anywhere, Mike.
No, stands right still. And again, and then beats his chest.
The two of them are really taking it.
And Mike Sharpe that time going for a drop kick, but the Warrior gingerly just walked out of the way.
The Warrior showing a little brains there.
Oh, what a clothesline by the Ultimate Warrior.
What a smack on that clothesline. What a clothesline.
Seems so easy for him. You know, he has different ring attire from the most. He wears those things around to maybe accentuate his muscles. Real different.
Well, I don't think the Ultimate Warrior needs much to accentuate that physique, Duke.
Well, just because he got a physique doesn't mean he knows how to wrestle.
It helps.
Now look at Mike Sharpe. There's a physique, and there's a guy who knows how to wrestle.
Well, I don't call a rake across the eyes a scientific wrestling move. Have a nice reversal by the Ultimate Warrior. Leapfrog. Scoop slam. Oh, my.
Wow, the way he picked him up like nothing. And another one of them savage clotheslines. Mike Sharpe out there just shaking the cobwebs out.
Mike Sharpe not at all happy at the way this match is going.
Get out of here!
Ultimate Warrior seems to be doing pretty good here, but we're not going to give him all of it yet.
Now Mike Sharpe is asking the Warrior to wait a minute.
Mike Sharpe is just going to outwit the Warrior.
Well, I believe Mike Sharpe wants to go into a test of strength with the Warrior, Mike.
Sure.
I don't think this is too good of a move for Mike to do.
Well, hopefully Mike Sharpe has some sort of strategy plan as the Warrior obviously overpowering Sharpe, but Sharpe with those boots to the midsection, suddenly the tide has changed.
Well, I apologize. That was an excellent move for Mike Sharpe. Absolutely excellent. Ultimate Warrior kind of in a bad position. Look at him. Huh?
You're the Warrior now.
Uh-oh. Only to come back up and be met by the end of Sharpe's boot.
That shows you how sharp smart is, huh? And how dumb the Ultimate Warrior is.
The referee asking the Warrior if he's ready to give up, and the Warrior says, no way.
Look at that savage face on him. The man is loco.
Look at those guns on the Ultimate Warrior. Oh! And the Warrior uses a kick to the midsection to his advantage now. Back Sharpe up into the corner.
Oh,
that
wow.
Right across the chest. You can hear it all over the building.
What a savage move. Look at that pounding. Look at the biceps on that Warrior.
Warrior followed it up and Sharpe out of the way.
Sharpe showing his ring genius. And the Indian just kind of running in there. The Ultimate Warrior kind of got a few cobwebs that time. Would you say, Mike?
I'd say so. But, you know, this is what I've always wondered about Sharpe. He has this piece on his forearm and it's used to an advantage. And it's not from an old injury.
It is just used to strengthen the wrist.
They say it's for an old injury, but...
The Warrior introduces Mike Sharpe into that top turnbuckle.
Will you look at that savage.
I don't think Mike Sharpe knows where he is.
Savage has gone loco.
Wow, good grief.
Flying body block, tremendous. He's gone crazy. Look at him. He's a local Indian there.
Winding up and socks it to him.
Unbelievable.
And the Warrior now is signaling he wants Mike Sharpe to go up.
Look at this. Look.
Look at this awesome display of strength.
And then up above his head.
Oh.
And drops him. Oh. That could be it.
Unbelievable strength on that Warrior. Unbelievable.
That's it.
That is it.
Look at the size of him.
The winner of the match, the Ultimate Warrior.
The Ultimate Warrior, the winner of the match, pounding his chest. And what an awesome display of strength.
Approaching the ring from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Weighing 283 pounds, claiming to be Canada's greatest athlete, Iron Mike Sharpe. His opponent from Antigua in the West Indies, weighing 239 pounds, SD Special Delivery Jones.
SD Special Delivery Jones out of Antigua, now making his home in the city of brotherly love.
I'm very happy there, I believe.
Philadelphia? Yes.
Well, it's the same as Antigua.
It is.
Yeah.
In what respect?
Well, I don't know. I've never been either. And character.
Obviously.
I've been to Philadelphia, but I mean, I can imagine it'd be the same as Antigua.
I understand they're holding some of your direct descendants responsible for the crack in the Liberty Bell.
I had nothing to do with that.
Yeah, well, that's... Mike Sharpe, wow, he made a true statement, Alfred.
Yes, he did.
He said, you don't have a body like mine.
He's absolutely right, I don't. But looking at his body, it's very powerful, obviously, and both of these wrestlers are power-style wrestlers, so we should see quite a battle here.
SD Jones sporting a new style haircut. Maybe Brutus the Barber got a chance to work.
No, B&D did it.
Yeah, who's that?
Black and Decker.
Black and Decker.
Iron Mike is your favorite wrestler, isn't he, Alfred?
He's one of your favorites. The brain said he's one of your favorites, Alfred.
Iron Mike Sharpe.
Iron Mike Sharpe.
Yes, I rather like him. I think he's extremely entertaining.
He needs a good manager, though.
He does, right? Indeed. Perhaps Bobby would consider that.
No, I said he needs a good manager.
Oh, I'm awfully sorry.
What does that mean?
But Iron Mike is what he is a willing wrestler. He'll take on anybody, and he's certainly faced some various opponents in his life. But against SD Jones, of course, he's going to have his work cut out.
Sometimes he doesn't have any rhyme or reason to what he does. That's why I said he needs a manager. He's very windmillish at times.
He is, but he never stops moving.
Oh, nice reversal. Look out. Big backdrop coming up. He got nailed. Here he comes.
Whoa!
Just like a bull in the china closet. Almost right out here in front of our broadcast table.
You know, as much as I don't really care for SD Jones, you can't take this man lightly. SD Jones is a very big, powerful man. His weight fluctuates. Sometimes he's 280, sometimes he's near 300. He can be 260, and he's a skilled veteran in the ring. Plus, he looks like Bill Cosby.
Well, earlier on, I was speaking to him in the dressing room, and he said you were very reluctant to sign a contract between he and Ravishing Rick.
He doesn't know what signing means. You're talking about writing your name and printing or using script. He doesn't know anything about that.
Yes, he does. Very intelligent individual.
Well, he's never shown me that.
Brought him in the hard way.
But he's a tough guy.
No question about that. A lot of guys will tell you that. A lot of guys getting it up with the short end of the stick. Nice leapfrog. Drop kick. Way too late.
Mike made two very nice moves in the beginning of that. Unfortunately for him, his third move, the drop kick, was not successful.
See, Mike should have made three good moves. The first two he did, and the last one to get a cab.
He may be doing that.
He may be doing the best move he can do all night.
Headed towards the locker room area.
No, he's too tough for that. He's going to be back, Mike Sharpe.
Well, he doesn't want to go home with the loser's end of the purse money.
Damn.
Terry Garvin now wandering over into that area. Referring to the Terry Garvin of the Terry Garvin School of Self-Defense.
Yes.
Many wrestlers have come out of there.
Well, Pat Patterson was a star pupil, I believe, in that particular
He went all the way to the Intercontinental Championship.
He did indeed, and held it with dignity.
However, it's been all downhill since then.
No, it's been upgraded now.
I'm talking about Pat Patterson.
Well, he's still on the downhill side, yeah, but
Mike is showing everybody just how strong he is, and I think he's going to try and outpower SD Jones, and I don't envy him in that particular task. Here we go. Locked.
Conditioning is such an important part of professional wrestling, and no one in better condition than Iron Mike.
You know, Iron Mike, before the match starts, he works out in the dressing room, in the hallway, in the showers for 3-4 hours. He is in great shape. He gets to the building like at 5:30, 6 o'clock.
Unfortunately, he doesn't do any homework. He just smashed SD's head into the turnbuckle, which is not the point to attack. Special delivery.
He realized that mistake after.
Yeah, but maybe he gave it a try. Maybe SD's head became mashed potatoes over the weekend. You don't know.
Highly unlikely.
Well, maybe from the inside.
You would know a lot about that.
The inside of mind thinking? Yes, I do.
Sharp now in control. Look at this. Eye rake. Is he going to drag him right across that rope? That'll give you a negative attitude. Make you wish you were back in Beverly Hills.
I wished I was.
Good blow by Mike there.
No, you don't.
Yeah.
I think he's concentrating his attack on the back and the neck, the upper back and neck of SD Jones, and it seems to be wearing Jones down.
Well, if I were an opponent of SD Jones, I'd be working on one of his legs, Alfred. Upper body's much too powerful. A little bit slow there. Telegraph that move. Look out. Atomic drop coming up. He nailed it good.
Was that a foul?
No, that was a stomp to the inner thigh.
Ah.
And Jones is pointing that out now.
Over backwards into the ringside area. Took the timekeeper's chair with him. Dangerous place to be. Nothing but concrete and steel out there.
But that doesn't appear to hurt Mike or faze him. is almost impervious to punishment.
Well, you can hit this guy with the 5'10 subway. It isn't going to hurt him.
Our number four handheld is, I think he's looking for hazardous duty pay right now.
I think he should. He only just managed to escape that. I'd hate to be hit by Mike coming out of the ring.
Iron Mike tied up now. Referee trying to turn him loose. SD taking advantage of the situation. There's that shot by number four. He hasn't headed for the third balcony yet.
As well may he should.
SD just sitting on that second rope, putting a little extra pressure on there. Referee trying to get him out. SD says, I'm going to help you. That wasn't too much help.
He knows every trick, don't he, SD? He really is a crafty ring veteran.
Mike, he cannot escape those ropes. He's really stuck in there. If he doesn't get out soon, he's going to be in a lot more trouble.
Well, those ropes are fairly tight. Cut off the circulation of blood there.
Yes, and your arms can have a...
Harry's got them out now.
They can be numbed for quite a considerable time and no strength in them at all.
Absolutely.
It's embarrassing going at midnight to Manhattan General and telling you got rope burn.
Rope burn. Irish whip coming up. Put his head down. Paid for it.
Well, Mike really clobbered him there, too. Took full advantage of that. So he's quite alert.
Of course, it depends where you have the rope burn.
Please. Family-type entertainment here.
That's what I mean. Under the arm, across the wrist.
Trying to get him down, perhaps for a backbreaker. No.
Tremendous power exhibited there by SD Jones. Great upper body strength. Just picks Mike up. Nearly 300 pounds with such ease.
No way.
Didn't cover him properly. Didn't take a leg. A sloppy cover, in fact.
See, now if he'd have done the headbutt in conjunction with the slam, he might have got him. But now he's too close to the ropes. Bottom foot right out of there.
That is always a risky move. I don't like that. If the referee doesn't lift his head, you're counted out and there's nothing you can do about it.
Another reversal this time by Iron Mike. Ducks underneath a big roundhouse right. Did not duck underneath that one.
Mike showing a lot of speed here.
Hooks the leg, got a little leverage here.
He got him! He got him!
Ha ha! What a fantastic.
It's not an upset. Mike Sharpe has out wrestled the man.
Sound like you had some money on this match or something.
No, I'm just glad to see SD bite the dust.
You're glad to see SD bite the dust.
Some great speed shown by Mike Sharpe there, and I believe, in my estimate, a very deserved victory.
Well, let's get the official word.
Here's your winner, Iron Mike Sharpe.